Oh, look at our little baby. He's so cute.
He is, and we should tell the doctor to circumcise him soon.
Excuse me? Why would we do that? Cut off a part of his body?
Servus and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Felicia. I'm originally from Munich, Germany, but have been living here in Cincinnati, Ohio, off and on since 2016. So this is the fifth episode of my mini series on random differences between Germany and the US. Make sure to check out the other episodes as well. Links are in the info box below. I've talked about peeing, ice cream, oil changes, and cats so far. So it's been a pretty wild mix of topics. And of course, we're gonna keep that up because today we'll talk about male circumcision, männliche Beschneidung. Now, as I've mentioned in the past episodes, this series is all about things that are pretty different in Germany and the US, but for which there doesn't seem to exist a logical explanation as to why the two countries would handle that differently. Or at least I couldn't find one. So let's get right into the facts. In Germany, about 10% of men are circumcised. Worldwide, it's about 33% of men, and in the US, it's 75%. So 3/4 of men are circumcised in the US. That's not only way more than in Germany, but also way above the worldwide average. Before I came to the US, I had no clue circumcision was common here. I mean, I never actively thought about this topic, but since the US is a Western country, with Christianity being the predominant religion, I just assumed that except for people from other religions like Judaism or Islam, and maybe some other people who do it for medical reasons and other reasons, the majority of American men wouldn't have this topic on their minds at all and would be uncircumcised. You know, just how it is in Germany usually. So when I found out that circumcision is pretty much the default here and that the vast majority of American men are circumcised, I wasn't only really surprised about this, but also had a lot of questions about it. And honestly, they still haven't really been answered. Only about 3% of the American population are Jewish or Muslim, so that definitely doesn't explain the 75% of circumcised men. So why is there such a big difference regarding cutting off a piece of somebody's body between Europe and, quite frankly, the rest of the world and the US if it's not for religious reasons? Now, I've heard a lot of people argue that it's for hygiene reasons because it's cleaner, but since we live in the 21st century and the US is a developed country, this really can't be the actual reason. Plus, I'm sure that all European men can confirm that it's possible to clean yourself even with a foreskin. Historically, circumcision, of course, has a lot of tradition in different cultures and religions, but it wasn't very common in the Western world until it had a revival in the English-speaking countries in the late 19th century. And that was for two main reasons. The first is that a lot of doctors at the time believed that the foreskin was connected to a lot of diseases and that circumcision would prevent and cure a lot of them, including syphilis, erectile dysfunctions, and bad wedding. Those all kind of make sense, but also other diseases like skin cancer or epilepsy. The second reason was that there was an increasingly negative attitude towards sex at the time, especially towards masturbation. They called it self-abuse, and people believed that circumcising infants and boys would prevent them from masturbating. For the same two reasons, some doctors at the time also practiced female circumcision, by the way, which fortunately did not catch on, unlike male circumcision. Fun fact, one of the many advocates for circumcision at the time was John Harvey Kellogg, the inventor of cornflakes, who was actually a medical doctor, and not only did he advocate for circumcision to prevent masturbation, but he also said that the consumption of Kellogg's cornflakes would prevent it as well. I mean, I gotta say, that's some genius marketing strategy right there. Now, obviously, today we know that circumcision does not prevent all of those diseases, unfortunately, and it doesn't keep men from masturbating either. So naturally, the number of circumcisions has gone down drastically in the 20th century, at least in most of the English-speaking world. In the UK, the procedure has to be paid for out of pocket since 1949, which led to a drastic drop, and it also went down in Canada, Australia, and New Zealand. In the US, however, the number was at 72% in 1950, and it's still at over 70% now. So why is that, America? Admittedly, the rate of newborns that are being circumcised is going down in the US. It's at about 55% of newborn boys right now, but I mean, that's still more than half, so still quite a big number and a lot of surgeries. Plus, most circumcisions in the US are done to infants, so I'm asking myself, why do parents decide to just chop off a part of their baby's body without their consent? I feel like they should at least wait until their kid is older and can decide about it himself. Especially since the medical advantages of circumcision have mostly been disproved, except for studies that suggest that it reduces the risk of HIV transmission. And yes, of course, there's also the aesthetic aspect, but again, a man can always choose to get circumcised once he's older. There has been a growing anti-circumcision movement recently in the US, with one of the leading organizations being Intact America. I'll put a link about that in the info box below, and there's also a lot more to read and learn about this topic. I recommend the episode of Adam Ruins Everything. It's really entertaining, and I'll link a few more websites down below. But for now, I really just want to know from you guys what you think about this topic. If you're American, have you ever doubted this practice? Have you done it to your children, or are you planning on doing so? Have you ever thought about valid reasons for this? And if you're German or from another country, what are your experiences with this topic? Has it ever even come up? Did you know it was so common in the US? What do you guys, men and women, think of this? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found this informative. If you liked it, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. And of course, you can subscribe to my channel for free and activate the bell to get notified about new uploads on this channel. The next episode of the Random Differences mini-series will be published in 2 days on Tuesday. But in the meantime, check out the other episodes. They're all linked in the info box below. And check out my other videos about German-American culture differences or about language stuff here on my channel. For more behind the scenes content, you can also follow me on social media, and I'll see you in 2 days with the next episode. Tschüss!